Hello, and welcome to the President's Panel on Transfer Success. I'm honored to be joined by two outstanding higher ed leaders and champions of transfer success in the state of Florida, Dr. Mark B. Rosenberg of Florida International University, and Dr. Madeline Pumariega, President, Miami-Dade College.
Transfers, in many ways, is our bread and butter. Largely, for those of us who are urban universities, we have a large urban population that needs educational services 24/7, 365. And so our use of transfer is a way to keep their educational hopes alive on one hand, and also to make it easy for all parties involved to understand what they're bringing in.
So I think the more we can talk about the communication about affordability, and then build on the 2+2, especially with areas like in healthcare and technology and STEM areas that we see our community needs in terms of jobs and does create economic prosperity for families. Talent is the new economic currency for states and communities that don't have the strong talent pool. They're going to lose out in terms of economic growth. So I look at it and I think it's a moral imperative that we make sure that we create pathways for individuals to be able to get that career, that job, that life sustaining for their families. It's certainly a social imperative in building those pathways towards prosperity. But most importantly, it's an economic, you know, imperative in terms of continuing to grow Florida, and especially right here in Miami-Dade County, making sure that businesses that come here, that start up here, have an opportunity to thrive here because we've got the right talent pool for them.
I think there's a lot of this that is mindset, and that, we expect you to get a college education, and we expect you to graduate timely. And if you do, we expect that you're going to help lift your families out of difficulty and into better circumstances. So I think we as educators have to make sure that we're speaking to that expectation, and that we understand that we play a critical role in uplift. And I think, truthfully, most of us in the state college system, in the state university system, are proud of that. We get that, and our frustration is we can't do more. Well, first of all, we have a sense of the importance of taking responsibility for the well-being of our community and the well-being of our students. I think that issue of mindset related to the values that drive our purpose-driven work, that's very important.
I think working on collaborative partnerships with community agencies, looking at emergency grant funding and being able to get that to students who sometimes academic careers derailed because of a flat tire.
Sure.
While you and I might have a flat tire called AAA and it's an inconvenience, for some students it ends that right there. And so I think doing those emergency grants are important, creating strong advising pathways so that they know the why. You know, we have a growth mindset. We want to impart in our students to have that same growth mindset. And when you do, that means you learn from places that the data says, boy, our hard work isn't reflective in that data. And then you also double down on your efforts to provide support for students and look at wherever there's a gap, how do we get intentional about closing it?
When do you expect us to quote unquote return to normal?
I don't think we ever return to normal. This is the new normal. It means enhancing teaching modalities. It means fine-tuning what we do in a virtual and digital environment. I do think that we're going to need to build and continue to build those bridges for students who now are working and creating what we've done previously, but now at a whole nother level.
There's a new normal and we got to embrace it. We've got to find newer and better ways to meet students where they are. We got to find newer and better ways to make sure they understand what's at risk if they don't get their educations. And we do have to find more resources, particularly to foster completion and them getting their educations done. I'm actually excited about what's ahead. We have demographics in the state of Florida. Those demographics are better than in most other states of the United States. And as a consequence, we've got work.
How's FIU preparing for this transfer success metric? And how do you think it might change the way that you approach transfer success?
Well, I'd like to think it wouldn't change it at all, to be candid with you, that in fact,
we
think
it's... We hope so, too.
I feel that as we can embed the transfer success metrics into our mindsets and our thinking, and we actually get the numbers and we see how well we're doing, I'm confident. We're a very competitive group in education. People don't think we're very competitive. We are, and we like to show that we can get things done.
What gets you excited about the transfer success metric and what you're going to expect as a president of one of our state colleges?
It is going to require some of that intentionality about making sure that students have strong academic pathways so that there's no loss of credit as they transfer in. It's going to require resources, thinking about a statewide transfer scholarship. Just like we have Bright Futures, how can we make sure that we remove any of the financial barriers for our transfer students? It's going to require some intentionality about being able to provide on-campus work opportunities for our transfer students, because many are working while they study.
So I see, if you will, a learning environment that is far more robust and far more capable of addressing the range of competencies and needs that our demographics will have and the economy will demand over the next 20 years. So I'm an optimist. I believe we will survive.
The way that right now we look at articulation is just this credit pathway, the blurring of non-credit and credit, much more of skill acquisition versus credit accumulation. I think that our students are going to have to graduate with three distinctive skill sets. One is the applied knowledge skill set, what we know traditionally today as our general education core. I think that's still going to be important over the next two decades, right? Having a global citizen is going to be incredibly important. The next set of skills are those future-proof skills, because students in the future are going to transfer from job to job. It's not going to be the career-long type of it, and I think it's the disruption in technology and automation and artificial intelligence.
Thank you. And thank you for joining us today. I want to thank both President Rosenberg and President Pumariega for their time and their talent this afternoon. We are truly in good hands when we have leaders like them leading us into the future. On behalf of the Florida Consortium and the Transfer Success Network, I'd like to thank you for joining us. Make sure that you put any comments in the chat, as well as any questions that you have, and we'll try and get to all of them. And come back in about 15 minutes, and we will resume the conference.